Mass, we pray for the soul of Francisco Mendonca. And we also pray for Marcela Pereira, who celebrates her 80th birthday today.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the coming of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the old era of salvation, God used prophet to bring his message to the people. God spoke to man as the situation demanded, teaching, demolishing, encouraging, and of course, consoling. Then the Babylon exile came. At this critical juncture, the need for prophetic ministry was keenly left, and prophet Isaiah met the challenge in the new era of salvation. We have John the Baptist and Jesus, who continues the prophetic mission. In his ministry, Jesus fulfills the prophecy of Isaiah by becoming the true shepherd of his flock. God is willing to come down to his people in the form of his beloved Son. Of course, his coming needs preparation. We should leave our mountains of agorism, hate, and other sinful tendencies, and establish values of peace, amiability, and gentleness. These will make our preparation for coming of our Lord and Master Jesus meaningful. Are we willing to bring repentance and conversion into our lives? Are we using the time of Advent for our spiritual renewal and purity?
With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our brother Francisco to be buried in its human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give him a merciful judgment and forgive all his sins. May Christ, the good shepherd, lead him safely home, to be at peace with God our Father. And may he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. Life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life, to show your fatherly care for all of us, and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our brother to paradise, and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith, until we all meet in Christ to be with you and with our brother forever. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Baba, don't agree. Baba, don't agree. Don't agree. Don't agree. Don't agree.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you. And even though their bodies lie in the earth, they trust that they, like you, will rise again. Give our brother Francisco peaceful rest in this grave, until that day when you, the resurrection and the life, will raise him up in glory. Then may he see the light of your presence, Lord Jesus, in the kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Since Almighty God has called our brother Francisco from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth from which he was made. Christ was the first to rise from the dead, and we know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. We commend our brother Francisco to the Lord. May the Lord receive him into his peace and raise up his body on the last day. Let us now listen to the Gospel reading. A reading from the Gospel according to St. John. At that time Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You trust in God, trust also in me. In my Father's house there are many places to live in. Otherwise, I would have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to you to take you to myself, so that you may be with me where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. So how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, I am the truth, and the life." Let our response be, put your hope in the Lord, take courage and be strong. Please repeat.
Put your hope in the Lord, take courage and be strong.
The Lord is my light and my help. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Before whom shall I shrink? Response.
Put your hope in the Lord, take courage and be strong.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord. For this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to savor the sweetness of the Lord, to behold his temple. Response.
Put your hope in the Lord, take courage and be strong.
For there he keeps me safe in his tent. in the day of evil. He hides me in the shelter of his tent. On a rock he sets me safe. Response. O Lord, hear my voice when I call. Have mercy and answer. Of you my heart has spoken. Seek his face. Response. It is the face of O Lord I seek. Hide not your face. Dismiss not your servant in anger. You have been my help. Response. Do not abandon or forsake me, O God, my help. Though father and mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Respond. Let us pray for our brother Francisco, to whom our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. The man who believes in me will live even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith. Our response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raised the dead to life. Give our brother Francisco eternal life. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother Francisco to the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Francisco was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give him fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our brother Francisco. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us now again call God our Father and Lord his daughters. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord, listen to our prayer for our brother Francisco, as he always desired to do your will. So in your mercy forgive whatever wrong he may have done. By his Christian faith, he was united with all your believing people. Now in love and mercy, give him a place with your angels and saints. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Give him eternal rest, O Lord.
Amen.
Yeah.